Hi everyone! Today I'll show you how to make stickers of your art for Redbubble and other print-on-demand sites. So this isn't about printing your own sticker sheets, it's just editing your traditional artworks for sticker designs to upload to these sites that fulfill the order, do the manufacturing and shipping for you. We're concentrating on art that has a portrait or a character and a background in it, and things like landscapes. So what I used to do, and what I think many artists do as well, is just upload the rectangular or square artwork to BOD sites, and it isn't a great design for stickers. So let's go through a few options as I update two of my older designs on Redbubble. I've already scanned or taken a photo of these paintings and adjusted the contrast, sharpness and saturation in GIMP, which is the free open source image editing software I use. So let's start with the deer painting. I'll make three different versions of it. I'll cut out the background first using the free select tool, because the background has a lot of colors and abstract shapes, so the color select tools wouldn't work, and I don't think the scissor select tool that uses intelligent edge fitting would work that well either. But you can definitely try those first, because they can make this part a lot faster for you if you have a big difference in color or contrast between the background and foreground. Make sure to add the alpha layer before deleting anything you've selected by going to Layer, Transparency and click Add Alpha Layer if it's not grayed out, which means that it's already on. Once you've selected an area, press Ctrl X to delete. And you can undo with Ctrl Z. If you make a mistake, you can move any of the selection points by dragging them, or you can also delete the last selection point by pressing backspace. I like to remove the background in sections instead of doing it all at once, so that if I accidentally undo the whole selection or something, I won't lose too much work. The time this takes depends on how intricate the outline of your character or portrait or object is that you're cutting out. I had some annoying areas here, like the round berries. I also decided to keep the four leaves since they're more in the foreground. So I selected around the leaf and then inverted the selection by going to Select Invert and then used the Eraser tool to erase around the leaf. While removing the background, I also wanted to quickly mention that if you haven't yet heard about FTC's COPPA regulation that's about to basically kill all art and craft and family-friendly channels on YouTube at the moment, I'll post links below where you can find out about the regulation and sign the petition for FTC to make the rules clearer, and also write them a comment about it by December 9th, 2019, whether you're a viewer or a content creator yourself. And back to the video. Once I've cut out the background, I'm checking that there aren't any stray pixels left by adding a background color. So right-click on the artwork layer, click New Layer, and you can choose to fill with transparency or a color. I went with transparency and then selected black in the color selector and filled the new layer with the bucket tool. Now I can more easily see if there are any areas left that I should still cut out. So this is one option you could use as a sticker. Hide the colored background with the eye icon beside the layer and just export it as a PNG file. But I don't like the way this bust shot is cut off in a straight line at the bottom. So I'll do another version where I round off the bottom. I'm taking the ellipse select tool and I have the fixed aspect ratio box checked, and the ratio is set to 1:1, meaning it's a square. Then I'm going to view and checking the box snap to canvas edges. This way it's easier to place the circle since it snaps in place to the bottom of the canvas. You can change the size of the circle and move it around to get the best placement. You've now selected what's inside the circle, but again you need to invert the selection in Select and Invert. And now you can erase the bottom of the image that's outside the circle. And you're left with a nice, symmetric, rounded off bottom edge for the sticker. I'm also making a version with a white outline, but you don't need this for stickers on POD sites unless your design is white and you want to add a dark outline so that it shows up on a sticker. But it's more for other products like t-shirts because you can make the design stand out on different colored backgrounds. I made the outline by using the Select by Color tool to select the transparent areas, inverting the selection and then growing the selection in Select and Grow and filling the outlined area with white. The third option is just to use the head, so I'm cutting out the neck part. And for the next sticker alternative, if you have a landscape or an abstract painting or something that doesn't have a clear character or an object that you can cut out, a simple way to make a sticker is just to cut out a circle. So again, go to View and check the box Snap to Canvas Edges, choose the Ellipse Select tool and make sure the Fixed Aspect Ratio box is checked. After placing the selection, make sure you have Alpha Layer added at Layer Transparency and invert the selection at Select Invert and erase the edges by pressing Ctrl X. You could also cut out some other shape like a diamond or a heart, but I'll save that for another video. Now let's go edit the Redbubble listings. So click Edit below the sticker and replace the image with the new sticker design. If you have problems uploading PNG images made with GIMP on Redbubble, open the image in another image editor like Paint 3D that comes with Windows and save it as a new PNG file and use that on Redbubble. I also went ahead and added the sticker designs on some of the other products like t-shirts. If you'd like to see more POD and image editing tips, click on the playlist on the screen. Thanks for watching. Bye.